Hello and welcome. I'm Raghav, and today I wanted to discuss with you some challenges that will be faced by testers in the coming years. And you can also look at it as some areas which can be improved, and it will help you a lot in your job. So this is basically a question that was asked to me by Sagar, and he says, please make video of the challenges for the testers in the coming years. So based on my knowledge and my experience, I have written down four major points, and these are: number one is skills, number two is automation, number three is process design and architecture, and number four is communication. Now I will be discussing this with you during the video. If you feel that there is some very important point which I have missed, you can always write it down in the comment section below. So you will see a comment section below this video, and you can write it there. And also you can let me know if there is something new that you want to discuss with me, which I can feature in the next video. So let's start by the first thing that I have written is skills. Now skills are very, very important in any job. And in today's time, you will see that whatever is your area of job, you will find that there is some new skills, some new tool, some new framework coming in the market every 2 or 3 months. So this is changing rapidly. The growth is happening rapidly, and it is very important that you keep pace with all these changes and with all the skills which are relevant to your job. Now, I'm not saying that you should go after each and every skills which is coming into the market, and you should invest all your time and energies in learning all the skills, but you can filter out what is very relevant to you and always have these skills added. So it will help you in making yourself more employable, and at the same time it will increase your skill set. So keeping track of the skills that are coming and which are relevant to you, and learning these relevant skills will be very important in the coming years. The second thing is automation. Now automation, I believe, should be looked at as a helping hand for your work. I recently created a video on automation versus manual, where I discuss the question, is automation better or manual is better, and what are the pros and cons. I will provide the link for that video in the description section below this video, so you can watch that as well. And coming back to automation, so let us take an example. You are doing 10 things in your job, and you have to do these 10 things every day. Out of these 10 things, there may be 3 or 4 things which are highly repetitive, and you have to follow the same sequence again and again every day. Now these are very good candidates which can be automated, and it can help you a lot. Once these are automated, it can save you a lot of time and energy which you can invest in other critical and creative things. Now it will be very important if you can learn some automation processes or tools which can help you in your work, and it will also add some automation skills for you. Now I get a lot of questions from people saying that we are from manual background and we do not know anything about coding or programming language, so how can we come into automation? And they feel that automation is very difficult, which is not exactly the case. You do not need to have a good programming or coding background. And if you look at any of the playlists on this channel, Automation Step by Step, every playlist I start with very, very basic from scratch. So if you do not know anything about that topic, you can learn from scratch and go step by step. So whether it is UI testing, whether it is API testing, whether it is Jenkins, JMeter, Catalan Studio, API, or Docker, every playlist I have started from very scratch. So even if you do not have any prior knowledge or any programming background, you can still learn it. So it will always benefit you if you can learn some automation skills, and it will be very helpful in your job as well. The third thing is process design and architecture. Now if you are into automation, you can think about it as the design and architecture of the frameworks. So it is very, very important that you design your framework very efficiently in the starting, because if you do not do that, once your framework is completed, you will have to invest a lot of time in rework, in maintenance, and whenever there is any change, you will be investing a lot of time in making the changes in your framework, which is not very good and ideal, because the whole point of automating is once your framework is ready, you should not have to invest a lot of time, and it should pay you back by saving your time and your energies and your money. So that is why it is important to learn the skills of designing a framework properly for automation engineers. And if you are into manual, then again, the processes becomes very important here, whether it is documentation, whether it is traceability matrices, whether it is the turnaround time from the defect being fixed to retesting to the final deployment. So all these skills will be very important in the coming years, and they are very relevant even today, so you can improve on them. The last point I have written is communication, and it is very generic but very, very important. And communication is you can categorize into two parts. The first part is the communication that you do within your team or within your project team members. And the second thing is, the second part will be the communication you do with the external teams. Now, I have observed that particularly the communication between the QA teams and dev teams may not be very efficient sometimes because of the kind of language used or kind of the way it is being communicated. So you should learn how to communicate or make the other person aware of your thoughts in a very proper way, and also in a way which is not offensive. So for example, if you are writing down the description for a defect, you should show that it is not you are not pointing out a particular team or a particular person's work, but you are just pointing out something in the application, and you should make yourself very straightforward, but at the same time very polite. And it goes the same way for any team and every team. So you should put across your thoughts in a way which is not offensive, and at the same time it is very useful and efficient, and actually helps in resolving some real world issues. So communication will be very important, whether it is inter-team or intra-team communication. So these are the four basic things which I thought I should share it with you. And if you think there is something important which I have missed, you can write it down in the comment section below. And if I find something very interesting and important, I will feature it in the next video. And if there is any question you want to discuss with me and want to feature in the next video, you can again write it down in the comment section below. And if you have not yet subscribed to this channel, I will request you to subscribe. You can hit the subscribe button and also hit the bell icon so that you can keep on receiving new videos from this channel, Automation Step by Step. I hope this was useful. I will meet you in the next video. Thank you for watching.